Hello there. Sometimes customers are in a bit of a dilemma because they love to have a real piano. They love the touch and the sound and the liveliness and really all those things that make a real piano slightly different to a digital one. But they've got neighbours, they don't want to disturb the neighbours, or there might be other people in the house, and the other people in the house don't like hearing the piano too much at times. So, what do you go for? Do you go for a digital piano for the convenience or a real piano because you love the sound and the touch, but unfortunately you may have to deal with the wrath of your neighbours or other people living in the house? Well, it's possible to have both because this is a beautiful Yamaha U3 real piano with all the gubbins and everything inside it. But I have added a silent system, which is an Austrian ad silent system, which I consider to be the best one. Sounds are really good on it. So what happens is you get the normal piano when you want to, but when you don't want to disturb the neighbours, there's a little lever on the end here, which is very neat. You flick it over, you pick up these headphones, which are neatly attached to the side. All you hear is that little knocking because a rail comes out inside the piano and stops the hammers from actually hitting the strings. And then it converts to a digital system with sensors under the keys and various other gubbins, which gives you the beautiful touch. What I can tell you is the touch is the same with or without the silent system on. So you've still got the proper touch of a piano, but not the sound. It converts to a digital sound, a very good digital sound. So obviously you're not hearing the hammers hitting the strings, you're not getting the acoustic piano, you're getting a digital piano when you switch it over. But this way you've got your real piano and a digital piano all in one, but with the real piano's touch. So that's quite important for some people. Let me show you the insides before I actually show you some of the sounds and what you can do. So here we are inside. It's the usual work that's been done on it. So really it's looking fantastic in there. It's all been reconditioned. This piano dates 1979, but you really wouldn't know it because it looks pretty much as new in there. And it sounds beautifully even. I've toned it all and made it nice and even, and I think it's a lovely piano. You've also got the practice pedal. The middle pedal doesn't operate the silent system as on some pianos. The middle pedal is still the muffling pedal. So if your neighbours or your family are in quite a good mood, you can have a bit of sound but still have the actual real piano sounding with that middle practice pedal, which on some of the other systems, the middle practice pedal is taken away because that operates the actual digital system from acoustic to digital. It does work with systems like Logic and GarageBand, so that you can sort of use really what you've got here. If you're into recording, is you've got a whole recording system, because if you connect it to your computer and to your recording software, which obviously you'll have independently of this, you need to buy that, but you can link it up to there and you've got all sorts of sounds on here. You've got string sounds, bass sounds, choirs, organs. I think there's well over 100 sounds on here, and I've had great fun playing through them all, and they're pretty good. It's got the AdSilent app, and it works with Android and it works on iPhones. So if you want to change the sound, all you've got to do is just change it from here. It's as easy as that. Bright piano reverb, piano 3, piano 2, piano 1. These are all the sounds. Look how many there are. Choirs, bassoons, clarinets, various synths,
Pan flutes, bagpipes, tuba, brass, all sorts of things on there. So if you do a bit of recording or want to get into a bit of recording, this might be a great option for you because you've still got your piano and you've got your sounds all on one device. So what I'd like to do now is show you the difference between the sound of the real piano, which is this. This is the actual hammers inside hitting the strings. And this now, I'm going to put this on. So I've switched on the lever so that now the hammers aren't going to hit the strings. We're going to go into digital territory. So this is the digital piano, and you'd probably put your headphones on so no one else can hear. But in this case, I've got speakers so that you'll be hearing it through the speakers. So this is the digital piano now. Piano 2. Great thing is the expression because you're getting exactly the same touch as the real piano. So you have no difference in the touch, which is great, really, because a lot of people find the touch different between a real piano and a digital piano, even with all the wonderful things they can do now. I think there's something about knowing that you're actually, there's moving parts in there and the weight is the same under your fingers. So that's great. We've got a mellow piano. Let me show you some of these other sounds now. So electric pianos, they're quite fun. Some pretty cool church organs. Turn it down a bit. Pretty cool. Various guitars. Choirs, fantastic. So, I mean, there's all sorts of things on here, and I'm skipping more out than I'm playing. Sitar. Steel drums. Thank you. what's happening is I'm enjoying it so much, I'm playing for far too long. But you can see how much fun you can have. And I haven't been a great advocate of these systems, but now I've fitted this one on here, I can see just how good it is. The system itself is very robust, looks very well made. It's a metal rail, so it's not going to warp or anything like that. It comes with a proper instruction manual for you so that you can suss out how to use it properly. So that's back to the real piano again now. So I'll just play you a little something to finish with, I think. So. So thank you for watching. Do contact me if you'd like to come and try this pretty amazing instrument. Okay, bye for now.